Welcome everyone to another Tracks on Sundays. I'm Tracks the Max, and this is another Raid Shadow Legends video. Guys, we got a fusion going on, White Queen Ancora, or Ancora, I'm not sure how you pronounce it, and she looks pretty decent, so we're gonna try and go for her, even though people are kinda ticked off. I've seen on Discord and stuff that people can't get her, but yeah, I don't know. I think I skipped last fusion just to be able to get a good fusion like this one. So, well, actually, that's a lie. I didn't skip the fusion. I skipped the path event for the ascending of the fusion. The fusion itself was really easy, but I didn't really want to waste my resources on the ascension for that. So, White Queen Ancora, what does she do? Attack one enemy has a 30% chance of decreasing the cooldown of a random ally skill by 2 turns, except this champion. That's really powerful. It goes up to a 50% chance, so basically this is happening 1 out of 2 times, right? And an ally skill by 2 turns. It's a random ally, but you can play around with this and really make a team work very well with this ability. So if this hits like your DPS in Hydra, for instance, well, you're going to do a ton more damage, obviously. If White King Narsa is on the same team and has any active skills on cooldown, decreases the cooldown of one of their skills by 2 turns. So instead of the random, I think it's this guy. I don't think it's both of them. That would be really OP, but if White King Narsis is on the same team and has no active skills on cooldown, decreases the cooldown of a random ally skill by 2 turns, except this champion. If the cooldown on a skill is fully reset, also heals that ally by 10% of this champion's max HP. That's really good. So you just get a lot of HP on her and she's going to be decreasing cooldown, healing. That's some awesome stuff. This alone is already like an S tier A1, like one of the best A1s in the game, probably. So the A2 3-turn cooldown removes all debuffs, so a full cleanse places a shield buff on them equal to 25% of this champion's max HP for 2 turns. If White King Narsa is on the same team, also places strength on all allies for 2 turns, then fills the turn meters of all allies by 10%. So you're getting turn meter, you're getting a big shield, and you're getting a strengthen on a 3-turn cooldown with a cleanse. Again, another ridiculous move. Basically 4 things in 1 on a 3-turn cooldown. So make her really fast and just keep on cleansing, keep on giving everyone turn meter, shields, protection. Really, really good. The A3 on a 3-turn cooldown again revives a dead ally with 50% HP and 75% turn meter, resets the cooldowns of the revived ally skills. That's, again, really crazy. So she's giving everyone turn meter, she's resetting cooldowns of people, she's reviving, decreasing the cooldown of some random allies by 2 turns. People are gonna be able to do their strongest skills, and that's all because of White Queen Ancora here. If the target is White King Narsis, revives them with 75% HP and 100% turn meter instead. Thing to note here is that 100% turn meter doesn't always necessarily mean in Raid Shadow Legends that they're going to go next. So keep that in mind, but they will almost go next normally. So after the revival, decrease the turn meters of all enemies by 10%. If White King Narsis is revived, decreases the turn meters of all enemies by 20%. Instead, this effect cannot be resisted. Okay, so if you don't have the king on your team, it's going to be 10%. If you have the king on your team, it's going to be 20%, and it can't be resisted. So ideally, you would want the king to be on your team so you don't have to build accuracy on her. But if you don't have the king and you build accuracy, then she can knock back the turn meter 10%, which is still really good on a 3-turn cooldown. That really sets up the champion that you just revived to, you know, do their thing instead of immediately getting killed again. So that's, yeah, I don't know. These three skills are just really busted already. This passive goes down to a zero turn. Whenever an enemy tries to place a fear, true fear, freeze, provoke, sleep, stun, or petrification debuff on the ally with the highest crit damage, transfer those debuffs to this champion instead. So that's basically all crowd control, right? Except for sheep, I guess. So that's pretty nutty. Fills a turn meter of this champion by 50% if this champion misses their turn due to one of these debuffs. Also really nice. And at the start of this champion's turn, remove any fear, true fear, freeze, provoke, sleep, stun, or petrification debuffs from this champion if White King Narciss is on the same team. So kind of like a reversed Siphi Roto situation, only here she takes all the debuffs for herself and removes them at the start of her turn. If there are multiple champions on the team with this skill, only one will activate. Well, that would have been completely insane if that would work with multiples. And she has the same increase ally speed in all battles by 19%, like Duchess and the good revivers out there. I think she's probably at the same level. She doesn't have a passive where she reduces the damage of anything, so like a Duchess has. She does bring a ton of cooldown reduction and turn meter and cleansing speed buff. Well, not speed buff, turn meter fill. Yeah, really crazy. And yeah, I think we should go for her. So I've already got 10 fragments, 5 from the Fire Knight here, and 5 from the arena. And if I'm not mistaken, we're allowed to miss on 10 fragments. So there's going to be 110 free, not counting winning tournaments and stuff like that. But I mean, I'm never really counting on that in the first place, because you end up with a whale or something in your bracket, then there's probably little chance that you're going to win that. So to summon rush, let's take a look real quick. We have to get 3,150 points. That's about usual, I'd say.
I say if I'm a rooster.
So, yeah, we're just going to pull some sacred shards here. There's also a 15 times chance to get one of these champions. So I guess we're going to fill in the archer here. Yeah, she's pretty good, right? I believe that's the last chance to get her too, so yeah, let's put her in there real quick. This one doesn't really matter. Alright. So we'll be pulling 6 of these and then doing the rest with mystery shards probably. So this is gonna be a quick video, and hopefully we can pull some gold here. See what we get. Nazana, ally protector, but we don't need that. Well, that's working. The clawed beast feeder. I've had enough of him already. If you've seen my videos in the past, you've probably seen me pull that guy several times. Knight Errant. I don't know if I actually had this guy, because there's a couple of epics, like OG epics, the ones from the beginning of the game that I still haven't pulled yet. This might actually be one of them, but I'm not sure. We'll go check later after this. There we go, gold. Harima, oh yeah. Now here's a champion. I mean, it's not the champion that they were offering us, but that's a champion right there. Ooh. Yeah, this is an arena master, right? Basically for this passive here, enemy ignore defense effects are decreased by 50%. So your savage and all that stuff, 50% in half, right? Champions from the Demon Spawn faction can't inflict critical hits. There's quite a few of these Demon Spawn champions in Arena. So that's a really, really good ability. I know because I play with a lot of Demon Spawn, and every time I see an Harima, I basically have to ban her because otherwise my team just doesn't do any damage. This champion cannot land weak hits on champions from the Demon Spawn faction, so she can easily ignore the fact that Duchess is Spirit Affinity and still just do the same damage on her as any other affinity. Her A1 attacks one enemy has a 50% chance, books up to 75% chance of placing a 50% decreased attack debuff for 2 turns, also has a 25% chance of placing a 50% decreased attack debuff on all other enemies for 2 turns if this attack is critical. You build her with crit rate, so normally this will be critical, so you basically have a 75% chance on one target and a 50% chance on all the rest that you're putting a decreased attack on the enemy team. That's really strong for an A1. The A2, 3 turn cooldown, attacks one enemy 3 times. Each hit decreases the target's defense by 5%, stacks up to 30%. Each hit also increases this champion's defense by 5%, stacks up to 100%. So if a fight goes on long enough, she's just going to rack up defense and she's going to decrease the enemy's defense, which is insane, really. Instantly activates Celestial Aoi skill if this skill kills an enemy, and that is the A3. The A3 also a 3 turn cooldown, attacks all enemies, places a provoke debuff for 1 turn. This debuff cannot be blocked or resisted if the target champion is from the Demon Spawn faction. Again, so very much anti-Demon Spawn, as you can see, but also just enemy ignored defense effects chopped in half, right? Crazy, crazy champion for Arena. Really good, really solid for defense. Just overall, super annoying to deal with. Has a ally resistance in arena battles by 80 if you would need it, but... And she hits hard if I'm not mistaken, so... Let's see... 4.9... Even Demon Lord Hydra... Yeah... Yeah, That's a winner! That's what we call a winner right there. Defense base, by the way, also, so... You will like to pair her up with someone who can bring a defense buff, but eventually she's just a solid unit herself, so. Okay, so let's go back and see how many points we actually have, because that is 2,000, so that was what? That was the 4th shard? Okay. Hey, I'll take it. Pretty good. So, 2 more shards. 2 more shots at this archer, and otherwise I guess she'll be gone forever, right? I don't really want to pull too many of these shards, because I kind of want to stay in range of a guaranteed if they ever do that again, so... Hopefully they'll do that again, and not all these stupid paths, because I don't really enjoy those too much. I don't think people enjoy them. And a Virgus. So that should do it here. 3,000 points, yeah. These 142 shards, I'll do mystery shards, and then we can finish this. Get these 15 fragments, and we will be at 25. If I'm mistaken. So 10 more to go here, and then we'll be at 25. So yeah, that will be all for this video. If you want to see the Only Voids account, I will be putting out a video later with that too. I just wanted to record these shard pulls real quick since it's been a while. I don't think I've done any shard pull videos this year yet, so just been too busy with the Only Voids account. How did your shard pulls go if you're going for her? Let me know in the comments, and yeah, be sure to go check out the Only Voids. There, a lot happened over there, so take care, guys.